Get up on the wrong side of the bed?
There's only one side. I sleep by the wall.
Oh, it's a figure. Forget it. You want to be in a bad mood? It's your choice.
I'm not complaining. My soul is dying, but I'm not complaining.
Figured moving out here to the Wild West would be exciting, right? Big adventure, never bored.
Didn't you?
No, I'm just here for the trouble, really.
I could use some trouble.
That's what they all say until they're in it.
Then what?
Then they meet me.
And there she was. Poor Agnes with her sick husband and five children trapped inside a cabin. She knew those outlaws were coming. She could hear their spurs jingling closer and closer. But Agnes, she stood her ground, steely calm. Then chaos. Three of the meanest, most vicious men you could ever imagine came bursting through the cabin door. And what did they find to greet them?
Do tell.
Her gun pointed straight at him. Stopped him cold. They said, woman, we come for your money, your jewelry, and everything you hold near and dear. Now drop your pistol.
And she did, of course.
I shall do no such thing, she said. What courage.
She sounds like a fool to me.
Don't say that, Wade.
A smart woman would have put the gun down and done as she was told, given the circumstances, of course.
But her husband was dying from consumption. She had five mouths to feed. She was just defending her family. You would have done the same thing for me, wouldn't you? Defended me?
Belle, my dear, these dime store Western novels are affecting your mind.
Well, they give me such pleasure. The days can be quite long without them, Wade.
Perhaps turning your attention to the more womanly arts will give you peace of mind.
I haven't the talent for needlework.
It's a pity.
But I promise I will reapply my efforts.
You are my lovely little pipit, aren't you?
Finish your dinner, honey.
It is a frightfully cold night.
Be of stout heart. The evening constitutional is vital for us both.
Mm-hmm.
So, this Agnes, the one from the log cabin?
Yes, my frontier desperado's heroine.
How did she manage to get herself out of such a pickle after all?
Well, she shot him. All of them dropped him dead.
Goodness gracious. Imagine.
Stop! Stop! What are you doing?
Don't be getting ideas, woman. Let's get.
Take these to the hotel directly.
Judge Shirley? Kate Warren. It's a pleasure to meet you. This is my associate, Will Pinkerton.
Your Honor? Sorry, I'm not sure how to address.
Chief Magistrate, Syene, Texas.
Syene. South of Dallas, right?
Southeast, actually. What have you heard?
It has a reputation. Mostly peaceful. Sheltered's not the word I'm looking for.
We received your telegram. This must be quite the ordeal for you.
I took the first train out as soon as I got the news. My daughter Belle is staying at the hotel.
I understand she's here in Kansas City on a visit?
With her husband, Wade Carson, yes. He works for Joseph McCoy out of Abilene. They had business to transact. Belle came along, which she does from time to time. Keeps her occupied.
Working for the real McCoy. Must be a cattle trader.
That is correct.
It's a lucrative business. Kidnappers may be after his money.
And mine, too. I'll be damned if they're going to get a nickel. But for the moment, it's my daughter I'm concerned about.
Father, what are you doing here?
Do you expect me to sit back in my armchair while my precious daughter is suffering such difficulty?
I appreciate you coming.
Who else could fix this mess? And I've taken the liberty of hiring some help. The Pinkertons.
It's a pleasure. I've read so much about you.
We're so sorry you have to go through this, Mrs. Carson. Have you had any word from your husband's kidnappers? After an abduction, there's usually a ransom note or some kind of communication.
Nothing. I've heard nothing.
I really think we should contact the sheriff.
No, absolutely not. We will not risk agitating an already fragile situation by making it public. I hired you for a reason. Keep it quiet.
Okay. Well, let's start with the man who took your husband. What did they look like?
Well, they were ruffians, to be sure. Two of them. But they wore red kerchiefs over their faces, and they had their hats pulled low. I really couldn't see much.
Come on, Belle. You must have seen more than that.
Honestly, it happened so quickly.
We'll do our best to find your husband, Mrs. Carson.
Now that we've all met, what's your plan of action?
We're going to wait to hear word from Wade's captors. We're hogtied till we do.
I hope you know what you're doing.
There's no question there, sir.
That remains to be seen, doesn't it?
Where'd this come from?
It was here this morning when I came in.
But you don't know who left it?
Mm-mm. I saw the note inside, thought you'd be interested. Is this about the kidnapping?
You've heard?
Who hasn't?
What are people saying?
A couple of outlaws barred a rich man.
The more appropriate term is abducted.
It's all exciting to me.
That's because you're not the one being borrowed at gunpoint.
Whatever people are saying, keep quiet about this, Mio. Not a word. Dear Mrs. Carson, dear spelled with two E's, want to grow old with your husband, put $2,000 in the satchel. I want gold and paper dollars, 3 o'clock today. Drop it near the cattle trough at Bailey's Corner. Do that and your husband goes free. Tomorrow you will find him in Kansas City by noon. If no money, he dies. Come alone, I'm watching.
Simple, clear, costly.
Possibly deadly.
That all depends on Belle and her father.
Is that all there is?
I sold my ruby bracelet for cash this morning. The emeralds are on pawn. What? Wade handles all of our finances, you know that.
There's no secret fund stashed for emergencies?
Father, if I knew, I would tell you.
Rest assured, Your Honor, we're experienced in these matters.
We'll take Belle out to Bailey's Corner. She'll deliver the money.
Alone?
It will appear that way. We'll be close behind her.
Just try to relax. All you have to do is walk out, drop the money in the trough. We'll cover you every step of the way.
I'm not convinced she's capable of doing this.
Yes, I can. And I will.
Good. Fait accompli. The deed is done.
Kind of cute when you try to impress me.
Yes, I am, and no, I wasn't.
Why the hell is she coming this way?
I have no idea.
She'll give us away if someone's watching.
How was that?
Keep walking, don't look at us.
Get to your horse and go back to the hotel now.
Kidnappers know we're here. They're keeping us waiting on purpose. They want us to freeze and give up.
Come here, warm me up.
Whoa.
You'll do the both of us good, seriously.
I'm not that cold.
Fine then. You just have to prove me wrong.
I just did.
Oh.
Give him a minute.
We're gonna lose him.
We can't risk him seeing us. Looks like he might be heading back to town.
Oh, good.
Why is that good? It's harder to track someone in the city.
I'm up for the chase. Might even thaw us out. Let's go. Why did you just get me to explain the whole thing?
I'll keep watch so who picks up the money. You follow the drop-off man. He'll probably lead you to where they're hiding Carson.
It's more likely the guy coming to get the money would do that.
But just hurry up and go.
I didn't kill you to be pleasant, you know?
Oh, I am. Just not when you're around.
Where's the money?
Oh. Oh. So that's what that feels like.
Will! Oh, God. Let's get you on your feet.
If you don't mind, I'm fine where I am. Thank you.
Well, you lost him.
I was so glad you're here to tell me these things.
Will, we have a problem. There's no money in here.
The satchel from the barrel? That doesn't make any sense.
Yes, it does. It means we've been played.
Oh, please. I don't think my manhood can handle a helping hand from a woman.
Yeah, I'm ignoring you.
You can let go of me anytime. You got duped. It's a 3-card Monty with 2-card showing.
Illuminate me. I know very little about card games.
It's a sleight of hand, okay? These two bags were filled with nothing, and then the third one, which was filled with the money, was switched out.
So the kidnappers got their ransom?
That's my guess. Damn Weasel's probably picking it up right now.
Then you can't be far. I need to speak with you straight away.
What are you doing?
Well, if the kidnapper's hiding, we'll flush him out. Kate Warren with the Pinkerton Agency. There's a fugitive on the loose. I'm going to have to secure the premises. Please, step aside. Get busy. Sure you didn't see anything. Thank you for your cooperation.
There's no sign of him. But this fellow here says that somebody matching our man's description stole his horse.
That's right. Held a gun in my face, made me unhitch my team. Stole the best mare I had.
But he didn't take the wagon.
No, man, he was in an awful hurry.
There's no surprise there. We'll do our best to find your horse for you, all right?
The wagon would have restricted him to road travel. That's probably why he took the single horse.
Could be anywhere. Where are you going?
I got questions.
So do I. Taking off?
You lost our money?
Not exactly.
Please, clarify yourself.
It appears there was no money in the satchel to begin with.
Now that's impossible.
We saw a man pick up the bag that you left in the woods.
He then switched it for an identical one in town. We retrieved both satchels. Both were empty.
All I know is I dropped off a satchel full of money, and now it's gone.
Please, would someone just tell me where the money is?
I don't think you caught my drift.
I caught it perfectly, sir. I hired you to rectify this situation. You've only made it worse.
Hold on a minute.
I hold you both responsible. Imbeciles.
Father.
And now my son-in-law is gone. Probably for good.
Don't say that. We'll find him, of course we will. There must be another bag with money in it.
Oh, hush up, Belle.
She has a point, sir. There very well may be a third satchel.
But we won't know for sure until tomorrow.
If the money was delivered, then Wade will be released in the morning.
And if he isn't?
If Wade doesn't turn up tomorrow...
And we both know what that means. Question right now is what happened to that ransom money?
Well, there are several explanations. Perhaps the money was switched out before it was delivered.
Belle, I thought about that. But why would she do that?
Or her father?
They both seem to want Wade returned to them.
Well, then there's a possibility that the money was received by the kidnappers.
Yeah, but how? And who are they?
I don't know. At this juncture, let's just hope Wade's still alive.
You can talk or you can bleed out.
I have no money, not for you or me.
Man, son of... Don't you pass out on me now. Talk!
Sister James, what the hell's going on?
You're not supposed to be here. Where's money?
The plan didn't go like we talked.
You were followed, weren't you? Did they see your face?
I'm not gonna lie to you, Jesse. All I know is I picked up the money and did the fake swish.
Good.
But the satchel, there weren't nothing in there. No dollars.
I never told you to look in the satchel.
Couldn't help it. I got tangled up. I was carrying around pieces of wood and horseshoes that whole time. Like I said, no dollars.
You got tangled up. Hmm? With who?
Couldn't say. But I hit him good. With a spade, no less. Down he went.
But not dead.
No, he stirred a bit.
He saw you.
Doubt it. Remember, I was fast on him.
You get hit by a man, you never forget his face.
I suppose. Jesse, what's going on? Messed up, didn't I? I'm sorry. I did what you needed me to do the best way I could.
I'm aware. There's no need to apologize.
Okay. Thank you.
Then you got something to say?
I was hoping you wouldn't show up alone.
There's no sign of Wade Carson. I checked the depot. There's nothing on the streets. I even went out to Hopkins Corner. We got nothing.
It's 2 hours past the exchange time.
It doesn't bode well. So either the kidnappers changed their minds or...
Or they killed Wade.
Right.
But it doesn't make sense. What's to gain from killing Wade Carson but not collecting the ransom? I mean, there's no logic in that.
And I'm not ready to give up this case and turn it into a search for a missing corpse either. So where does that leave us?
The bearers of bad news. With an agenda, mind you.
Oh, how very warm of you. Almost caring, with a hint of comfort.
Well, we all have our faults. We need to find out what happened to that ransom money. It could be the linchpin in all of this.
Wait, we lost it.
No, they took it.
Right, but who is they?
Exactly.
Exactly. Well, see, we can agree on something. It's not going to kill you.
What? Look, I'm going to attend to Belle and see what I can learn from her. I suggest you do the same with her father. Well, be discreet with your questions. Act like you know less than you do. Act vacant.
Yeah, be myself. Thanks, Kate.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
Please don't look at me that way, Mr. Pickett.
I'm sorry, Judge. I looked everywhere. I think the kidnappers still have him.
Wade's dead, isn't he?
We don't know that for certain.
I think we do. Why would they do this? That same thought would have been the last one that Wade ever had. What a horrible notion, to leave this world full of fear and questions.
You know, I don't have your experience as a judge, or your wisdom. And I'll admit, the situation does look pretty grim. But maybe you can tell me, how is it you're so sure Wade is dead?
I just refuse to believe it. Wade's alive, he has to be.
Your optimism may be rewarded.
It will. I have no choice but to believe my husband's waiting to come home for me. This is a nightmare. But nightmares come to an end.
Possibly I miss something.
That's putting it mildly. You managed to lose both the kidnappers and the ransom money. That is to say nothing about my future. In a few years' time, I'm going to be put out to pasture, and then what? Miss something? Well, thank you to wipe that smirk off your face.
Oh, sorry, I just noticed your novel, Frontier Desperados.
Have you know I'm also reading Margaret Fuller's Women of the 19th Century? Don't be so quick to judge.
I have that issue, a Frontier Desperados, with Agnes the Avenger.
Obviously fiction.
It speaks to a certain viewpoint.
She is a virtuous woman protecting her family, that's true.
And in love with danger. Perhaps that's why those novels are so popular. The gateway to freedom, fantasy. Out on the range, six shooters, the excitement of the unknown.
Reckless tales of adventure, just childish whimsy.
But for a married woman, what would your outlaw name be?
Star. Belle Star.
Belle, are you happy in your marriage?
What the hell kind of question is that?
I think you just answered it.
And what about you? If you were free to be whatever you wanted out there, what would your name be?
Mrs. Kate Warren.
Mrs. Detective Kate Warren?
Yes. Always.
Mm-hmm.
By all accounts, my daughter and Mr. Carson had a trusting bond under law and under God.
And would you also say that they were in love?
Don't be caustic with me.
Oh, no, this is me being vacant.
I'm not paying you to be vacant, nor to question Belle's integrity.
I meant no offense. I'm just trying to understand how much they meant to one another, outside of their marital contract.
Wade was a lucky match. Belle was grateful that fate brought them together. And to be honest, he probably saved my daughter from an early demise.
How so?
Even as a child, Belle was spirited and obstinate. She needs to be reined in. Wade helped with that.
Well, he is used to handling cattle.
Do be careful with your words and tone, Mr. Pinkerton. I have no patience for your playful jabs. I come from a respected Southern family with roots in the French aristocracy.
Meaning that you provided Wade with the status, and he provided you with the money to keep it.
It is not entirely that simple.
It's an arrangement as old as the hills. Chief Magistrate of Cyene, Texas. Meaning you had money in a Confederate bank, right? Then the war came along.
And the Union Army plundered my fortune. Yes.
All of it?
The ransom money? The money you lost track of? That was the last of my savings. My only blessing is that my father is not alive to see what has become of his family legacy.
Dead broke. That explains a few things.
No, it doesn't. Belle's father is living off of Wade Carson's money. You wouldn't have him kidnapped.
That's not what
And Wade wouldn't dare stop giving his money. He'd lose Belle and the link to the family name.
Belle could care less about losing her husband. I think she's been roped into a loveless marriage.
Kate, your aim's way off. The way the judge was talking, Belle and Wade made a great couple.
Father may have designed the marriage, but he's not the one living in it.
She could do worse.
Well, she could also do different.
Have a drink.
I'm just saying, Belle wants to be free.
Of what?
Of everything. Everything that's expected of a young woman.
And kidnapping her own husband makes sense how?
Take the money and run. I'm not saying that I agree with her morals. I'm only suggesting that Belle craves adventure.
She gets adventures, that is true. I can hear this woman having adventures at night with another man. She thinks nobody knows, but I do.
Belle's having an affair? With who?
A handsome man. Young. Like her.
When?
Well, well, getting up to the devil's business, huh?
I didn't get a good look at his face.
Oh, go knock on the door. Should be on full display by now.
Please act your age for once.
I am. All right, you stay here. I'm gonna go outside and keep an eye on the balcony.
What am I supposed to do?
Let them finish.
Pulling a knife on a woman.
It's preferable to a gun.
Oh, what a gentleman.
Al, please, watch what you're doing.
Sorry.
Damn it.
Will, calm down.
Not until I see Jesse dead on the end of a rope.
And how do you plan on doing that? We have no idea where he went.
I'll find him myself. You're not going anywhere with that wound.
The lady upstairs. She'll tell her where the man goes.
As sure as you live, we'll get Belle to talk.
A confrontation won't help us.
Kate, we don't have time for a nice chat with Belle. Her husband could still be alive.
He might be. But at this moment, Belle has no way of knowing that for sure.
Don't follow.
But you might. Belle could lead you directly to Wade.
Come in. Something's wrong. I can tell by your faces. Goodness, what happened to you?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you.
Mrs. Carson, our investigation has unfortunately taken a bad turn.
In what way?
Belle, we found Wade. Please sit. I'm sorry to tell you, but your husband's dead.
It can't be.
His body was discovered this morning under a pile of refuse just outside of town.
You must be mistaken.
No, there was no mistake. His face matched the photograph that you provided. The clothes were identical to the description you gave when you last saw him.
I don't believe you. I want to see the body.
I'm afraid we can't allow that. Wade's body's with the Undertaker and is not in a presentable state.
What did they do to him?
He was beaten quite badly.
Whoever is responsible was likely trying to extract information from Wade. Financial gain, perhaps.
This doesn't make any sense. How could you have allowed Wade to die? I entrusted you to solve this.
We will. I promise you.
If I have learned anything in life, it's that promises are worthless.
Hold on.
The third satchel.
It's empty now.
Oh, how sweet. She stole from her father.
It would appear that way.
Heaven, he at least told you where the money was.
No, not yet.
Not yet? You mean Wade's?
Wade is what?
He's alive.
Of course he's alive. He hasn't talked yet. What made you think different?
Because I've been set up by the Pinkertons. They told me he was found dead this morning. Somebody see you leave the hotel?
More than that. The woman tried to block my way.
Kate?
Yeah, I know her name. She knows my knife.
You should have killed her when you had a chance. We don't have much time.
Now, whose fault is that?
Give me your pistol.
For what?
Give it to me.
Bell.
Wade, you and I both know that our marriage was manufactured. An arrangement between my father and you. I'm sorry to say, but I'm gonna have to break that contract. There are laws against what I'm about to do, but not here.
Why do you want to do this? My wife.
Simply business. Always has been. And now you have to pay. If you refuse to say where your fortune is, I refuse to let you live.
I don't have any money in hiding.
You don't trust the banks. I know that. Which means my divorce reparations must be in safekeeping somewhere else.
Wade. If you tell me where your fortune is, I'll set us both free.
No. No, I'm dead to you either way.
True.
Wait, please.
What the hell is that?
Someone's outside.
Quiet, woman.
Okay.
I'll tell you where the money is.
But you have to see why you are doing this.
I want freedom.
I have given you everything a woman would want.
How do you know? You never asked me what I wanted, Wade. I have no desire to live the way you expect.
You think life is like a dime store novel? I can understand the excitement, but you want to be hiding out in a cave, eating rattlesnake? You wouldn't last a week.
Go on, Belle. Get on your horse and get out of here.
You won't get very far.
You haven't thought this through.
I'm moving on whether you're breathing or not. Where's the money?
In our garden. Near the bench, under the brickwork. But I have to tell you something. There's barely anything left, Belle. The money's all gone.
You spent it? On what?
I speculated on the cattle market. I made some bad business deals. I've got enough for maybe 6 months at the most.
Liar!
Sadly, I'm not. It's the truth. Now, you go on and you pull that trigger. You shoot me. I'm done.
Go on, Belle. Get on your horse and get out of here. You can wait for me. I'll be right behind you.
Belle, please come home. All is forgiven. Please.
I'm well aware of that.
I will never forgive her.
She may never forgive you either.
How dare you?
With all due respect, sir, you exerted a lot of pressure on your daughter.
I did no such thing.
It's a lot to ask of someone to save your financial injuries with their marriage.
It was her duty, madam. I have to admit, you Pinkertons did a fine job.
Thank you.
But what you found was not what I wanted to see.
Perhaps you needed to. Good day.
So, Will captured a real outlaw?
Yes, they punched each other until one of them gave up. Sounds pretty exciting, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Unbelievable.
News from St. Louis?
Yeah, guess what they found in Wade Carson's garden?
Probably nothing.
Wade was telling the truth.
So how much money was buried there?
Wasn't even enough to cover a train fare home to St. Louis. Wade was just as broke as Belle's father.
So Belle was the only one who gained anything from all this?
After leaving a path of destruction.
They're all playing the same game. Belle just punched a little harder.
Well, good luck to her.
Somehow, I don't think she'll need it.
Next week on The Pinkertons.
I will declare the truth on the pages of a new voice in this wilderness.
It's General Sterling Price. He's ruthless during the war.
I know who he is.
I rue the day that Price rolled into town.
I think Price has something to do with the murder.
You say no to me! Bring him in here, boys!
Are you right with God, General?
I will not be silenced!